You can now make your own effects. Effect Maker lets you create and customize effects that you can publish for other creators to use in their content. With Effect Maker, you can create simple effects like these, or more complex and interactive effects like these. Effect Maker is available on desktop. After creating a project, you can upload images or 3D models, create or add filters, and make other adjustments until you're happy with how your effect looks. Once effects are created, any eligible creator can use them when recording shorts by clicking on the effects icon in the main toolbelt in the shorts camera. Let's walk through the basics of how to start creating an effect, as well as how to navigate the Effect Maker tools and features. We'll also show you an example of how to create a simple effect using Effect Maker. To get started, go to Effect Maker at effects.youtube.com from a computer. To begin creating an effect, click the plus sign under Start a Project. You will then be taken to your project page, where you can build out and preview your effect. In the top bar, you will see the project name. You can click it to change your project name at any time. You'll also see several icons you can use to manage your project file. Undo and redo, which you can use to undo or redo a change you've made in your project. Save status, which you can click on to see that your project was successfully automatically saved to your account. Effect performance, which displays your current file size and memory usage. Change layout, which allows you to switch between a layout with or without the visual scripting editor. Preview on device, which brings up a QR code you can scan with your phone to preview your effect. You'll also see the submit button, which lets you submit your effect for review once it's ready. If approved, your effect will be available for use on YouTube. Now let's walk through the main tools you'll use to create and edit your effect. The transform tools allow you to manipulate the objects in your effect, as well as toggle between a 2D and 3D view. As you add objects to your effect, you'll be able to select and use Move to grab and move objects around, Rotate to rotate objects, and Scale to make objects bigger or smaller. The tools in the sidebar are where you'll add the elements that make up your effect. Clicking the first icon brings up your objects and assets. Objects are the core building blocks of your effect. Each object has a specific function. Assets are the files and data that the objects use. The same asset can be used across multiple objects. You can also use visual scripting to change which asset an object uses. The Objects tab is where you'll see the objects currently in your effects project. In this tab, you can drag to rearrange the order of the objects in your effect and toggle on and off the visibility of each object in your effect. The Assets tab is where you can upload files you want to use in your project. This tab stores all the elements you may need to build your effect. All the icons below the Objects and Assets icon are the tools you'll use to add the elements and objects for your effect. Color filter is where you can create a color filter or upload a LUT to import a color filter. Click Use LUT to upload a color filter you've already created. If you prefer to create the color filter in Effect Maker, click Add Filter. The Properties panel will then pop up on the right side of the screen. Here you can adjust the different color properties until you are happy with how your color filter looks. You can also select any LUT you've uploaded to add it to your effect as a color filter. As you create and add color filters, they will be added to the Objects tab. Any LUT files you upload will be added to the Assets tab. Next is the image icon. When you click on it, you'll see options to add an image or add an image sequence. You can click Add Image to import still images or GIFs. Clicking Add Image Sequence and uploading an image sequence adds an animation of that sequence to your effect. Any images you upload and add to your effect will appear in the Objects and Assets tabs. Next, you can add face effects. There are three different types of face effects you can add: face paint, face accessories, and stretch. Face paint is where you can upload an image that will get mapped onto the effect user's face. You can also download our face reference file here to help you correctly format and position the asset you want to use as face paint. Use face paint when you want to add makeup, face paint, or face tattoos to your effect. Face accessories is where you can upload images or 3D models to use as accessories, stickers, or other decorative objects around the face. When you add and position an image as a face accessory, that image will be linked to the subject's face and move when their head moves. Stretch is where you can manipulate the proportions of the face in your effect to make it larger, smaller, or distorted. Clicking Add Stretch will pull up the Stretch tool. Here you can click and drag each stretch point on the face to manipulate it. Next, camera and segmentation. Clicking Body Segmentation, then Add Body will cut out the person in your effect from the background and create a copy of the person and add that copy to your effect. This copy will appear as a body segmentation in the Objects tab. You can then move, rotate, and adjust the scale of this body segmentation. You can also click Add Body and Background to upload and change the background image behind the person in your effect. Selecting Camera Feed, then Add Camera Feed, will add a real-time camera view from the phone's camera that you can use to create effects with a picture-in-picture or blur. Next is the text icon. Click to add text and add it to your effect. You can adjust how the text looks in the Properties panel on the right side of the screen. Next, 3D. Here you can add 3D models and lights to your effect. If you add a 3D model, you can add lights to add realism to the model by adding highlights, reflections, and shadows. Finally, let's walk through visual scripting. Visual scripting is a tool you'll use when creating interactive effects. Interactive effects are effects that change based on how someone is using the effect, like this. When you click on the visual scripting panel, you can use the following nodes, which are script building blocks, to create complex logic for your effect. Triggers. These are nodes that start or activate a sequence of actions based on specific events or conditions, such as when the screen is tapped. Logic. These help you make decisions within your script by evaluating conditions and performing actions based on whether those conditions are true or false, like if an object is visible or not. Control flow. Control flow nodes manage the order and timing of actions in your script, allowing you to create loops, wait for a certain amount of time, or execute actions in a specific order. Objects and properties. Objects and properties nodes allow you to change objects' attributes, such as their position, rotation, or opacity. Math. These nodes manipulate numerical values in your script by performing various math operations. Time and utility. These help you manage time-related actions in your script and manipulate data. Note that as you create and make changes to your effect, you can see them reflected in the preview at the bottom of the Effect Maker. In the bottom menu of the preview screen, you can click Play to watch the preview video in motion, Pause to pause it, Reset Effect to revert the effect to its initial starting state, View Camera to use your device's camera to preview your effect, and View Video to change the model used in the preview. Those are the basics of Effect Maker. Once you've created an effect you're happy with, it's time to submit your effect. Click Submit in the upper right corner when you have finished editing your effect and are ready to submit it. You will then be prompted to upload a thumbnail image. You can use an image processing tool, screenshots, or other illustrative methods to create and design the thumbnail. You will then be asked to name your effect. Names should accurately describe your effect. The visibility of your effect is automatically set to public so anyone can find and use it on YouTube. You can add a description that reflects the effect to help others easily search for and find your effect. If your effect uses visual scripting, you'll also be prompted to select instructions based on the type of trigger nodes used to help effect users understand how to use your effect. Your effect, effect name, and effect thumbnail will be reviewed to make sure they adhere to the guidelines before they are published on YouTube. It could take a few business days for an effect to be reviewed and published. To view the status of your effect, you can check in the Manage tab on the homepage of Effect Maker. An effect will either show as In Review, Active, or Needs Revision. When an effect is active, the effect is live and usable, but note that it may take some time before it's visible in the Effects Picker. If your effect is marked as Needs Revision, it will not be published, but you can make changes and resubmit your effect for review. Effects will be rejected if they don't follow effects policies related to technical aspects, violative and/or harmful content, effect name or thumbnail. Check out the Help Center article linked in the description of this video for more detailed information about effects policies. If your effect is approved, your effect will be available for people to use on YouTube. Now let's walk through an example of how to create a simple alien effect using Effect Maker. First, let's start a new project. Let's title our project Space Alien. Let's begin by adding a color filter to create an overall green tint for our effect. Click Color Filter, then set the tint in the Properties panel to negative 100%. Next, let's make the subject in the effect have a green-colored face. Go to Face Effects, then Face Paint. Upload an image of a large green square. Then set the blend mode in the Properties panel to Multiply. This will make the green color blend into the person's face. To really make this effect otherworldly, let's stretch out the subject's face so that it looks even more alien-like. Go back to Face Effects, then click Stretch. Move the stretch points until you're happy with how alien-like the effect looks. Now let's add some alien antenna to the top of the subject's head. Back under Face Effects, click Face Accessories, then Add Image. Upload an image of green antenna, ensuring that the image has a transparent background. Then move and resize the image of the antenna to the top of the subject's head. To finish our effect, let's put our subject on Mars. go to Body Segmentation in the main panel and click Add Body and Background. Upload an image of a cartoon planet landscape. You can use the Move and Scale tools and the Transform tools to adjust the position and size of the background image in your effect. Let's take a look at the effect in action in the preview screen. You can click the View Video icon in the lower right corner to change the model and see how your effect will look like with different people. Congrats! You've just successfully used Effect Maker. We hope this helps you better understand how to use Effect Maker to create shorts effects. Try it out, and don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube Creators channel for more creator tips, news, and updates.